Okay, so some thoughts on eyewear, sunglasses. This can be a bit of a pain trying to find a good set of outdoor sunglasses for mountain hiking and mountaineering and climbing. Chiefly because we face a lot more irritating challenges than in normal everyday sportswear. So, for example, sweat, fogging, the fit around the face has to be just right. As soon as there's a big temper difference between the outer and the inner lens, all kinds of problems can arise, resulting in you not being able to see. Glare is a big problem, particularly in conditions like this, where it's covered with snow. Obviously, you can see the sun right up there. That's one problem. It's very bright, powerful sunlight, but hey, I'm wearing sunglasses, it's fine, right? Well, the problem is the reflected light from the snow. So you get an awful lot of harmful blue light and infrared light as well. So that means that eyewear for mountains needs to be a bit more specialist. And I mean, you can pay an awful lot of money for essentially a nice pair of sunglasses. You don't necessarily need to. I've got two pairs with me today. I always carry two pairs just in case I lose one, because I'm prone to doing that. Or if I scratch the crap out of it on a rock, because I'm not very careful with them. So I've got two pairs of Julbo Shields. Now, they're called Shields, I think, because they come with a little side shield, which is a really good feature. Eye strain can be a bit of a problem in the mountains as well, because the light's bouncing around off the snow everywhere. So these little eye shields are something good to look out for on a pair of sunglasses. Really simple little thing, but really, really does help with eye fatigue. Also, on all of these models, I don't know if you can just make it out, there's little holes all around the frames. And that helps with fogging or anti-fogging, and it helps vent the air and create a bit of airflow. So you can actually get a buff right under here and breathe normally without it fogging too much. I've got quite a forward forehead, so if you've got a big fat head like me, then the fit for most sunglasses is probably a bit too close to your eyes. Okay, if it's touching your eyebrows and you can feel it a bit close to your eyes, that's absolutely no good, because they'll just fog up straight away. They shouldn't be touching. You shouldn't be able to feel them. So these are kind of a semi-wrap, maybe you call them. They're just curved enough without being too acute. They're nice and big. They cover the full eye socket. Thinner ones probably won't cut the mustard. Again, because there's so much light coming in from different angles, you want a big, fat, beefy pair of sunglasses. Lenses are something to consider. For mountains, Cat 4, Category 4 lenses. Light transmission between 6% and 8%, something like that. Category 3, which is what most normal sunglasses are, including sports sunglasses for road running, etc., etc. You can get away with them, they're absolutely fine. But you probably find that your eyes are straining and you're a bit headachy towards the end of the day. If you're on snow, a lot of Category 3 lenses don't enable you to read the snow very well, particularly with quite contrasting light. That can be an issue as well, particularly if you're on reasonably acute snow angles and things like that. Polarization is a bit of a question mark. I personally don't like polarized sunglasses for winter mountaineering, just because they mess around with how the light interacts with the snow and you can't read the snow particularly well. You don't really need polarization either. It's a bit gimmicky. It's more for water and reflected glare. As long as the sunglasses have got a good anti-glare coating, it's fine. These particular ones, this model, have got a reactive lens, so from Cat 2 to 4, which is quite useful if you're in changing terrain, as a lot of mountains are. I mean, if I flip you over that way, you can see over here, bright sunlight. If I walk 5 minutes that way, I'm in the shade. And you don't want to be taking them on and off, on and off. And they are quite quick to react, by and large. These ones, essentially the same thing. Different lens, though. These are just a mirrored Category 4 lens. Mirrored lens just means it's reflecting all of the harmful UV rays and things like that. So if you don't have polarization, make sure you do have a mirrored lens. So yeah, some things to watch out for when you're choosing eyewear. It is a really important piece of kit if you're going to spend a reasonable amount of time out in the mountains.